Hey, this is Brian Knowlton with Your Boss Blows. I'm going to teach you how to make money online. Through my video interviews and step-by-step tutorials, I'm going to teach you how you can make a little extra money at the end of the month or turn it into a full-time gig like I currently run my online businesses. So I hope you enjoy this episode. Hey, I hope everyone's having a great week. You know, I just got back from Affiliate Summit, and while I was there, I was able to attend some awesome masterminds. And one of the best mastermind that it attended was with David Ford here, and he's the host over at AF Playbook, Affiliate Playbook, that is AFPlaybook.com, and had a really great session. I think it was like 4 hours long, or 6 hours. It was crazy long.
It was.
Yeah, that was great. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me.
Are you all caught up in sleep from Vegas?
I think I'm getting there. Yeah, it was quite a whirlwind, but it was a lot of fun and got to meet a lot of people and see a lot of people from the forum that I know only by screen names. So it was a really good trip.
Yeah, it was amazing. And, you know, I've been a member of the forum since last year, and I haven't been super active inside the forum, been really focusing on bringing more and more video content to my viewers. But every time I go in there, it seems like I'm picking up something new. It's just filled with tons of great information. And I would say it's for everyone from newbies. You have sections specifically for newbies, but there's a lot of experts in there as well. And the thing that I really like about it is everyone's willing to share information. Has it always been that way? Or
it has, yeah. That's one of the things I worked really hard at when I was growing the forum, and still to this day, is just making sure it was a place that everybody wanted to share information and felt comfortable doing so. I came from a background where, you know, I went to all the other various forums beforehand, and, you know, on some of those, depending on where you go, newbies can really get shot down, or, you know, there can just be a lot of trash talking between people and stuff. And I really didn't want that. I just wanted to cut all that out and, you know, make it a place where it was the cool thing was to share information and, you know, kind of flex your brain muscle, if you will, and share your knowledge that way.
Yeah. Well, that's what I've kind of found is, you know, on a lot of these other forums, it's like a dog eat dog mentality, and you ask a simple question and you get flamed to death. You know, there might be 1,000 replies and they're all just making fun of you or something. So it's really a horrible situation. Is that what, I mean, that's what inspired you to open AF Playbook, or was there something before this?
No, not really. I was an affiliate marketer for probably about, about 6 years or so, 7 years before I started the forum. And, you know, I was a member of other forums, just mostly visiting. And I was getting really into PPV marketing, doing pop-ups. So there wasn't a lot of information out there on that, and I decided to write an ebook. I thought, you know, this would just be a good little side project. I know a lot about this. I'll just write it and see how it does. So I wrote it in a weekend, and I sold it, and it made a lot of money selling it. And
wow.
So I got all these customers, and people were saying, hey, do you have any way I can contact you? And a few people said, what do you think about doing a forum? And I thought, well, okay, I guess. Nothing I'd ever thought of. So I put up the forum, again, not thinking that, you know, much would happen with it, but, you know, I put it up and a few people joined here and there, and then all of a sudden it just kind of snowballed, and we went from, you know, 5 members to 20 to 100 to 300 to 500 to 1,000, and it just kind of kept growing and growing like that. So
wow.
It was not a grand master plan to build this big of a forum. It just kind of happened.
Yeah, so now you have thousands of members inside the forum. And how long has the forum been open?
I started the forum, I believe, in December of 2009.
Wow.
So it's been a little bit.
Yeah. Wow. That's great.
Yeah.
Prior to starting that and writing that ebook, how long were you doing internet marketing before that or making money online?
I was doing it, I would say, for about 6 to 7, 8 years or so.
Wow.
When I started, I was doing system support. I was basically, you know, doing computer networking at a large retail chain, and I would travel around to their stores and do that. And it was a really good job, and I liked it and everything, but there was just no opportunity to do anything more with it. I was, you know, making as much as I was ever going to make there, and there was really no room for advancement. And I came from a really entrepreneurial background. You know, my mom was an entrepreneur and my dad was. And so I just kind of always had that mentality, and that's ideally what I wanted to do. So I just started looking around. I thought, you know, I have knowledge about computers and I can, you know, figure out how to do things, and I'm pretty technically proficient. So I started looking around at ways to make money, and I tried a bunch of different things, and then kind of didn't work. And then I hit on building content sites, just monetizing with, you know, either AdSense or various affiliate offers. And it just kind of took off from there. You know, I remember when I started, I thought, you know, if I could just make like $100 this month, yeah, you know, that would be like two times I could go out, you know, that month or something. And so, yeah, that's just kind of how it started. And then I did both that and my day job for about a year and a half to 2 years until I got to the point where I could quit my job. I could actually quit before then. I was just a little bit scared to do so. Yeah. I didn't really have the confidence, but once I quit, it was definitely the best decision I ever made, and then it just kind of took off from there.
Wow. How many content sites do you think you had at a time? Like at your peak?
Oh, wow. I would say hundreds at one time, maybe. Yeah, but, you know, as with anything in affiliate marketing, that was just part of it. And I did other stuff. I, you know, eventually got into pay-per-click advertising and, you know, doing all kinds of different stuff.
Yeah, because I did a bunch of content sites back in the day as well. And I was like, if I could make each website just make $30 a day, you know,
uh-huh,
and I'll build 100 of them, and I'll, you know, and I unfortunately was not able to scale to that large of a number.
Yeah.
Things start to fall behind and you move on to different things. So, but when you decided to write that ebook, was that your first product that you ever made, or was it free?
It was. No, it was a paid ebook. I believe I sold it for between $37 and $47, depending on where I was selling it and what kind of discount I was giving. So, yeah, that was the first kind of product I ever did. And if you look back at it, it's not very polished or anything. It's just kind of
yeah.
But it was – the content itself was good. You know, it was good information. And like I say, at that time, there wasn't a lot of information about that type of marketing going. So it sold really well, and that's kind of how I sort of, you know, made a name for teaching this kind of stuff.
Yeah, that's amazing that you created a product. You had no idea that it was going to explode like this, but it completely changed your life.
So. Yeah, it definitely did. It's funny to think back on it and everything. If you had asked me before, I just thought, you know, it was going to be this little side thing.
Yeah.
So.
Wow, that's great. Well, you know, that party was awesome. I wish you guys could have seen the suite. What was it, on the 58th floor or something like that?
Yeah, 57th floor of the Palms Place. It's a celebrity-owned penthouse, so it has, you know, you saw an amazing view of the strip and a hot tub on the balcony, and
yeah,
it's really nice to get to visit there and throw a party.
Yeah, I'm going to have to show in. I'm going to splice in some little video clips of the video of the scene from the back, because you could see all of the strip. That was such an amazing view. And the hot tub right there. Wow, I bet that hot tub has seen some pretty wild action in the past.
I bet it has, yeah.
Well, you know, during the mastermind, you talked about a lot of really great ways to, you know, inspire people to make money online. And you were talking about newsletters, making money with newsletters, product creation, and a number of other ideas. What do you think, you know, just even with content sites and creating products, if you were trying to help a newbie get started, is there any specific direction you would send a newbie in? Do you ever give advice to people and say, you know, this is a simple way to get started?
I do, yeah. It helps, obviously, if I know the person or something, like if they're a member of the forum and I've seen what they're posted and I can gauge kind of what level they're at.
Right.
But as far as building sites or doing newsletters or something, I usually recommend people start a little less ambitious than they might want to, and that might sound a little counterintuitive, but what I see happen a lot with people that I've coached over the years is they come in and they're really, really gung-ho and ambitious, and so they do all this stuff, and they end up getting burnt out because it's just too much to handle, or it's too much, they get frustrated with some technical part. So I usually tell people it's better to start with something that you can totally handle 100%, even if it's just like building one site a month. You know, you're much better doing that, building one site a month over 12 months, than sitting down and saying, I'm going to build one site every day. And then you might do that for 5 days. And then, you know, your friends want to go out one night and you do that. And then your mom's sick and you have to do something else. And then you just get off this rhythm. Then you start beating yourself up because, oh, I didn't stick with my goal and everything.
Yeah.
So I like people to do that because then they get the momentum going forward and they're having more successes than frustrations, you know?
Yeah.
You can always scale. It's much easier to scale up than it is to scale down and, you know, kind of go back to the beginning.
Right. So set some goals that are attainable. Don't set these really high, lofty goals. Even, I mean, you don't even have to set monetary goals in the beginning. It could just be, you know, I need to get that website up in a week. And then my second one, I'll do it in a month. Third one, a couple weeks. You know, just follow that path. Did you have any more advice on that, Harry?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's a really good point, just to basically stick with a plan and a formula, at least when you're starting out. And I think a lot of people get frustrated because they think there's going to be more money than there is when they first start. You know, like when I started, I said a bit ago, I was – aiming for, you know, a couple $100 a month, which sounds funny right now. And probably to most people, you know, coming online now that see all the blogs talking about people making lots of money, you know, they think $200 a month. But,
yeah,
you know, that was what I shot for. And so, you know, I was building sites for months before I hit that. And then when I hit it, it was like I had hit the jackpot, you know. I was like, this is the greatest thing ever. So I see a lot of people missing out on that, you know, that sense of accomplishment because they're looking at themselves as a failure if they're not making, you know, $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 a month.
Yeah,
so
that's crazy.
You have to have fun. Yeah, you have to have fun with the process.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I find being really passionate about, you know, what if you're doing something that you already have a passion for, I find that makes it way easier for me. So, yeah,
yes,
that's this kind of stuff that I tend to stick to. And also, if you're an expert in any specific area, that's why a lot of the stuff that I do has to do with marketing for appraisers or teaching real estate appraisers how to run their business better, different things like that. I have a passion for it. And if you have a passion for something, you know, I always think that's the best way to get started.
Absolutely.
But some things that really intrigue me inside of the forum and that my best friend has been a part of for years now is just really, you know, media buys and PPV, pay-per-view ads and pushing offers and things like that. I would have to say that's probably more towards the intermediate to expert levels. But what's your feeling on that for someone looking to say, this is something that I am interested in doing. How can I get started?
Yeah, so the forum is mostly focused on affiliate marketing. And the majority of the content lessons we have are built around paid traffic, so PPC, PPV, media buys. You don't have to be an intermediate or expert to do any of that. In fact, I've written a bunch of step-by-step lessons. So if someone comes in and they're like, I've never done PPC before, where do I start? I have a series of, you know, threads that, you know, go from A to B to C.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and we do have other free traffic generation methods, but those are more, you know, geared to building long-term stuff and stable stuff. That's one of the things that we've really focused on over the last year is building, not just doing paid traffic to affiliate offers or even free SEO traffic to affiliate offers, but doing affiliate offers in conjunction with building some kind of sustainable business, like the stuff that I talked about in the mastermind.
Right. So what, for something like that, I know that's a topic that would require hours and hours of discussion, but if someone is looking to get into media buys and things along that line, in a nutshell, is there a way to explain it in a nutshell for people that don't even understand what the whole concept is?
To get into media buys itself?
Yeah, like how would you monetize buying traffic, buying, doing the media buys? How would you monetize that?
Sure. So the basics of buying traffic are there are networks that sell traffic to you for a cost, and you basically send that traffic to a landing page you build that is promoting an affiliate offer, or you can just direct link and send that traffic straight to an affiliate offer. And you can get these affiliate offers at places like ShareSale, or there's different CPA networks that pay usually on a per lead basis. So Google AdWords is an example of this. If you go to Google AdWords and you search for car insurance, you'd see that results down the middle, but then on the right you would see the AdWords ads.
Right.
And what those are paid ads. So I could create an Google AdWords account, go on there and say, I want to promote car insurance. I would create an ad and bid on certain keywords that I wanted my ad to show for, like car insurance. So that means when someone goes to Google and types in car insurance, my ad will come up on the right, on the paid ad spot. And if someone clicks on that, I have to pay, you know, say 50 cents for that click. And I'm hoping that they will then, you know, sign up through my affiliate link to a car insurance offer and I would make $14 or something.
Right.
I have to say I don't recommend doing car insurance on AdWords. That was just an example.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So the basic idea is you would buy the traffic. Say you spend, you know, $1,000 for a couple thousand hits or a couple thousand click-throughs to your advertisement. Out of those couple thousand click-throughs that get to your landing page, you're going to want to optimize that, make it the best experience for the customer, and then if they actually click and follow and sign up, then you'll get a commission. And so you get, you know, it could be any number, really. I mean, there's all sorts of different commissions from dollars to hundreds of dollars.
Yeah, it really is. And the Google AdWords example is just one form of traffic. Like you mentioned media buys, and what that generally means is you're just buying a banner on someone's website in the most simplest form. Now, there's really fancy technologies that do this. You can go through ad exchanges and different stuff, but actually you can get started doing what people call media buys really, really easy. All you need is a banner that you've made, you know, the standard banner size, and you just find a site you want to advertise on. You go to them and you say, hey, I'd like to buy, you know, this banner spot on your site for a month. How much does it cost? And you negotiate a rate. They'll put up your banner to going to whatever link you want. So you can link to a site that you own, a product you own, or just an affiliate link. And then when people visit that website, you hope to get them to click on your banner, go to your affiliate site or your site and convert.
I see. And what you're promoting is you think instead of sending people to the direct offers, and you're kind of promoting more of sending it to a website that you control?
Well, here's the thing. You know, affiliate marketing has been popular for a really long time. What I'll call pure affiliate marketing, which is just sending traffic to affiliate offers. And that's great, and it's something that I do and I'll probably always do. But in the last probably year for sure, a lot of people have been starting to go, okay, this is great. You know, we're getting all this web traffic. through all these different kinds of advertisements, but we're sending it to somebody else.
Right.
You know, I mean, so I'm getting, say I get 10,000 visitors a day that I'm sending to a car insurance offer. You know, that's 10,000 people that I'm basically acting as an intermediary pass-through.
Right.
So kind of the thinking that's finally starting to take place out there is that, you know, you want to retain the user as much as possible. So you can do stuff as simple as collect an email address and then send them to an offer, or you can do what you were talking about, which is sending them to something that you've created.
Right.
So just using the car insurance example, you could do something really easy. You could, say, create a, you know, 10-page ebook on you know, ways to shop for car insurance, or, you know, how to find the best car insurance deals. You could either offer that for free, and you could have people opt in to get this, and then they download the ebook and they read it. You could have affiliate links in your ebook, so, you know, you're getting commissions hopefully when people click on that, but you also have their email address,
right.
So you can keep marketing other stuff to them.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a really smart idea. You know, you mentioned earlier that the different tutorials that you have inside of the forum, and I've been spending a lot of time watching walkthroughs. Can you tell the viewers about the walkthroughs and, like, how often they come up and, you know, the contests that you have?
Yeah, we do a few different things. So one of the things that's most popular is follow-along campaigns, and that's where people basically post everything about their campaign, almost like a journal type entry. So they create a thread and they say, this is my, you know, media buy follow along campaign. And then every day or every couple of days they post updates to it and they say how much traffic they've sent and maybe what landing pages they're using or the banners. And so myself and everybody else in the forum can chime in and help say, you know, I think this is a good idea. I would not do this. You know, maybe you can cut this keyword here. So we're giving them advice along the way, and those are really helpful. Probably the most successful members that I've seen in the forum have done at least a few really detailed follow-along campaigns. They really get a lot out of it.
Yeah. Is there any chance we can see the inside of the affiliate playbook?
Yeah, definitely. So do you want me to give you a little tour here?
Yeah, that'd be great because, you know, I've been looking at a lot of the follow-along campaigns, and then I've been checking out the different forums for – like the success stories, but I haven't really looked at the different tutorials that you have. So I'd be really
sure.
Interested if you could just show us around. That'd be great.
Yeah, I'd be happy to. So when you first log in here, this is at the top, you have some stats here. This is just showing you the latest posts and some stats like top posters. Like you can see, I just hit 10,000 posts here.
Wow.
And yeah, and top thanked.
That's,
and then
I like that latest post feature. That's really awesome. I tend to go there first just to see what's going on.
Yeah, yeah, it's a great feature to kind of get an idea of what's happening. And then down here we have the general forum where we have stuff like announcements or any contests we're doing and general discussion. We have sections on design and coding, landing pages, a section for tracking, different various forms of tracking. We have a set of tools called AFPortal tools, and those are different. We have some landing page builders and some keyword tools, a bunch of different tools that are really helpful for a lot of the stuff that we teach. We have a specific newbie corner. If anyone feels like, you know, they don't want to post a question somewhere else or and they just feel more comfortable, they can post it there.
Oh, that's great.
So down here is where we get to more of the lessons. And here we have case studies. So if I go in here, these are all the case studies that we've done. And what the case studies are actual full case studies of campaigns. So I'll take a campaign that I'm running or I ran in the past, and I'll show everything that I did with it, how I – researched the offer, came up with the keywords, or how I promoted the site. So we have those all in here, and they're categorized by traffic source. So if I go down here and I change this thread prefix, say I wanted to see the PBV case studies,
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it can do that. And then you can see all the PPV case studies that we've done. So there's quite a lot of case studies in across all the different traffic sources.
Wow, that is a ton of information.
It is. And then here on Lessons and Tips, we have the same thing. We have – this is lessons and tips that aren't specific to any traffic source. So these might be lessons about landing pages that you could use on any traffic source, or something about it, specific coding.
Wow.
And let's see. So this is the section we were just talking about. This is the follow-along campaigns. So this is where people come in and they say, you know, these are the campaigns that I'm running, and they lay out exactly what they're doing with them. So they'll show their ads. You see they're in all different traffic sources, POF and PPC, and we have some people building different things. So it's pretty cool. You can see a lot of these are really long. I mean, this one right here is 7 pages here already. That one just started on the 9th, so just a week or two ago. So, yeah, it's really active. People really like that section a lot.
Yeah, I find that, you know, you get such great feedback when people are asking questions or they're just posting what they're doing that day, that they get a lot of really great feedback for tweaking campaigns and making improvements, you know, so, and to keep you just going, keeping you motivated. I find that that's a great part of the follow-along campaigns, and I want to start posting some in there soon.
Yeah, for sure. It's a really great thing. I would encourage anybody to post a follow-along campaign, because they do work and people learn a lot from them. And we also have contests every once in a while, I think you were mentioning, where we do a follow-along campaign contest and people, you know, do their campaigns for 2 or 3 weeks, however we're doing it. Then we have some prizes that we give away for first, second, third place like that. And those are also really popular.
Wow, that's awesome. What's the webinar replays? I haven't even checked out those yet.
Yeah, so we do webinars. It's not on a set schedule. It's an average of maybe one a month, month and a half. And we just do these on various topics. Either it's myself or I'll have a guest on. You know, here we had Site Scout, the Media Buy Ad Exchange. We had them on there. We had an internet marketing lawyer on there. I did one on productivity and business planning. So there's a lot of different stuff on here, and the webinars are really good because people get to come on and ask live questions, and they're really helpful.
Wow, that's awesome. Well, I know that the F Playbook keeps you very busy. Do you have any new grand plans for the future? Anything else coming out of the box?
Nothing that's ready to be announced yet, but yeah, I'm definitely always planning stuff and, you know, working on new ideas. I really like doing the forum though, so it's going to be something that I'm always growing and expanding and adding to as I learn things. You know, then I can teach new things in the forum, and that's pretty fun to do.
Yeah. Running a forum is a lot of fun, but it's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work. So, yep.
Well, that's awesome. Well, I really urge everyone that really wants to learn and to learn from a community of people that love to share information with each other to visit AFF Playbook. It's AFFPLAYBOOK.com. It's super affordable. I would hate to tell you, but I would have paid double to get in.
Oh, man. I'm going to change your price really quick.
Yeah. But I love it. So I urge all my viewers, go over and check it out, aftplaybook.com. And thanks, David, for spending this time with me. I know you're a busy man.
Thanks. Yeah, anytime.
Awesome. Well, I'm going to definitely have you back maybe in a couple months, just get some more information. Maybe if I finally run my first follow-along campaign, we could have you in here to talk about it.
Sure.
All right. Well, you take care. And until next time, just do it. Well, I hope you really enjoyed that episode. You know, I've been receiving a lot of really good comments and questions off of my website about how to earn money. So what I'd like you to do, if you're interested, is send me an email. You know, any questions, comments, and I will be answering any type of questions and answering the comments in my upcoming shows. So just visit the website here, submit your information, and I'm going to be answering those for you. Another great thing is a lot of people have been going into iTunes and rating my show in there. I'm not sure if you're watching it on iTunes or YouTube or Roku, but in iTunes, you know, you just log in, give me a 5-star rating, or is it 5-star or is it 3? I'm not sure. Find out. Just go there and rate my show and put in a comment there. That really helps me out, get more exposure and able to bring more shows to you. Same thing with Roku. Just go to the title screen for the show, rate me in there, and that just brings in more viewers. So I really appreciate that. Really helps me out a lot. And if you're looking for that WordPress hosting, want to get a WordPress website up instantly, go to mybluehosting.com. Send me the information if you'd like, and I'll install your WordPress blog for you. So thanks again for spending your time with me. And until next time, just do it.